Hello, it is I, Kubi. Welcome if you are new, welcome back if you are not. So today we will be talking about like a guide to being a law student and what you need to know. This will in no way be extensive, but just the basics of what you need to know. So without further ado, let us begin. Okay, so firstly, a general overview. So law, studying law in Nigeria takes first and 5 years in every university and one extra year for law school to learn like the practical aspect of law. So unlike most people think, when you're studying law, you don't study a specialized aspect of law like in engineering, where you study civil engineering or mechanical engineering, you just study law. And yeah, I think that's all you need to know generally. So for the courses, in 100 level, I'm attending University of Benin, but I'm sure this is the same everywhere. In 100 level, you study only one law course, and that is legal methods. For the rest of the courses, you'll be borrowing courses from like Pole Department, Echo Department, ENL, and so on and so forth. And this is my personal opinion, but 100 level is the level where everyone seems to have low grades, mainly because people are not used to the freedom, or they believe that the courses are easy, all courses they are taking are easy, or just for some reason or the other. But better be careful in 100 level so that you don't rake up like carryovers, because they get pretty hard to manage as you progress. So in 200 level, that's when like the real law starts. You start offering more law courses like a Nigerian legal system, constitutional law, was it 90? For me though, I don't know about you, it may be good for you, but it was a nightmare for me. You offer law of contract, and I think the electives differ from university to university, but in University of Benin, you have to decide whether you want to do administrative law or customary law. I chose to do customary law. You also study one borrowed course, and in first semester it is computer, then in second semester it's history of Nigerian government, which is a pole course. So in 300 level, that's when things start to get intense. They are like, okay, we've treated you nicely for the past 2 years, it's time to get into it. So you start offering courses like criminal law, commercial law, law of tort, and then you offer one or three electives. And as I told you, electives differ from university to university, but in University of Benin, you offer law of succession, which is what I'm offering, or oil and gas, or environmental law. And then you have one borrowed course. This semester is in social psychology. Second semester is also going to be social psychology, but they will add one extra borrowed course, and that is computer for law students, something like that, but it's computer course. Now I'm in 300 level, so I can only tell you from 100 level to 300 level what you are to expect. So I don't know all the courses in 400 level, but 400 level is like the baba of all levels in law. Then 500 level, there are few courses, mainly because of their project. Their project takes a lot of their credit load, and the courses in 500 level are just... Okay, so apart from grading and courses, what else? I'm looking at my paper. Okay, dress code, yes. So law in general, in all universities, I think all Nigerian universities, the dress code is black and white. Now depending on the university you decide to go to, their dress code rules may be strict or lenient. Like in University of Benin, their law dress code is strict. For boys, you have to wear a white long sleeve shirt, button down shirt, with black trousers, and not, as my lecturer say, Michael Jackson trousers, long to the floor trousers with black socks, black shoes and a tie. You can add a suit or a waistcoat if you want, but that is not compulsory. And your hair must be cut short. No long hair, no dada, no, you know what I mean. Then for girls, you can either wear a long sleeve or short sleeve button down shirt, a skirt, no trouser. That is the one that's pinning you. For girls, you don't, they don't wear trousers and now I have to wear a skirt every day. Okay. I'm good. So I'm your skirt, black skirt, then black shoes, and your hair must be either black or dark brown. Must be packed, must not be too razz. And your earrings, your jewelry must also be minimal. You can carry any colored bag you want, but they advise you carry black bags. So yeah, you can wear a waist jacket and a suit also, but it's not compulsory. I heard that in University of Lagos they are a lot more lenient with their dress code. That so far you wear black and white, they don't care. Then in Ekpoma, that is Ambrose Ali University in Ekpoma, they are even more strict that you must wear suits. So if you happen to enter University of Benin, don't be too sad, because it could be even worse. You could be in Ambrose Ali University wearing suits in this heat. So there's always a silver lining. So the next one is social life. I'm going to talk about social life now. Now, if you are a law student, can you have a banging social life? Maybe. It depends. Now, if you want to be studious, as in you want to be attending class, you don't want to miss any class in your life, or not your life, but you want to be studious in law, your social life might suffer a bit of strain, because I've noticed from professional courses, that is medicine, law, and maybe I don't know about engineering, but mostly medicine and law, their timetables are more packed than average timetables. And people are always saying, Kubi, you're studying only 5 courses, you're so lucky. But sorry, you are not lucky, because for other, let's say for example, an English and literature student in University of Benin, maybe one of their courses will take only like 2 hours a week, 1 hour a week. No, there's no 1 hour a week course in law. Either 2 hours or 3 hours, or if the teacher likes book too much, they will add an extra 1 hour on top. And if you're 100 level or 200 level, your classes may end like that kind of 12-1. But from 300 level, you are not going home till 4. I have a timetable on Tuesday from 8 till 4, back to back. So on Saturdays and Sundays, obviously, are free, and you might want to like go out or stuff during the weekend. But if you are not ready, you have not finished reading your cases, you have not finished reading your book, you have not done your assignments, you have not read and studied for your pop-up test, because law lecturers, they love pop-up tests, then your conscience will just be killing you as you are going to that party. I'm not saying that you are going to have to be in the library 24/7. I'm just saying that if you want to be serious in law, you may not have as much free time as, let's say, any other students not doing a professional course will have. I am also not saying that students not offering professional courses are not offering important courses. I'm just saying the time limit is a lot. The time, you know, time is a lot. Okay, next up is hostel life in general, whether you're a law student or whether you're not a law student. Now, I can only speak from University of Benin side. So if you're about to go, if you want to go to another university, it might be similar but not completely. So if when coming to school, if you want to stay in hostel, you can either stay in the average masses hostel or the rich people hostel. That is not how they actually call it, but that is how it is for me. So like hall 1 and hall 2 for girls, if you're a girl, those are like the average Joe, don't have any connection people hostel. Then hall 5, hall 6 is like the you are happening, you have connection, you are 8 Hostel, and you also have Keystone. Now, Keystone is like a self-contained hostel, which is like the highest of the high posh 8-girl hostel. Then, if you don't want to stay in school at all, you can stay off campus. I stay off campus. People stay off campus for numerous reasons. Either they didn't get hostel, they don't want the stress of packing from hostel to hostel every year, me. Or they just want to be alone. They can't handle the enormous amount of people in one hostel. Like in hall one, there are 6 bunks in a hostel. And that 6 bunks, it's not only 6 people that will stay there. 6 people are legally allowed to stay there, but you'll just be seeing 13 people in one hostel. You'll be wondering how it's possible. For hall two is even worse. I think they are like 8. There are 4 bunks, so there's supposed to be like 8 people in a hostel. But they'll be like, let me not exaggerate. Okay, I'm exaggerating. 10. There'll be 10, 12 people in your hostel. And hall 6, there are only 4 people in your hostel. And I'm saying only, but in a school like University of Nsukka, UNN, there are only 4 people in a hostel usually. So, as I said before, it depends on the hostel you are. It depends on the university you want to go. So I think that is all. If you have any questions, you can comment down below and I will answer to the best of my ability. If I cannot answer it, sorry. So I guess that is it. Goodbye.